The alert height is linked to the aircraft that has an autoland with failed operation. In today's video, we will talk about this alert height and we will understand why it is important and what are the actions that a pilot should do if you have a failure in the automatic landing system before and after the alert height. So without further ado, let's jump right into it.
V1, rotate.
So the alert height is a very important thing, and it's a very important aspect to take into consideration when you are performing an autoland on a failed operational aircraft. So it's linked to the autoland system of the failed operational aircraft. So if your aircraft is failed passive, the alert height doesn't apply to you. Or if you are flying a manual landing, the alert height is not applicable to that specific approach. However, on a day with low visibility, you're performing an autoland and your aircraft is failed operational, the alert height is a very important height to take into consideration. What is this alert height? The alert height, as it says, is an height above the threshold at which, if there is a failure on your automatic landing system on a failed operational aircraft below the alert height, it is considered safe to continue even with a failure on the automatic landing system. This is so because the system is so redundant that it can perform an autoland even without failure. But that doesn't mean that we blindly, below the alert height, that doesn't mean that we blindly land regardless of the failure. Because the aircraft with failed operation with alert height, we should have an autoland red light. Okay, normally these autoland red lights will illuminate if the failure is so big that even though you are below the alert height, you should perform a go around. But if that's below alert height, the autoland red light doesn't illuminate, you can continue even though you have a failure on one of these autoland systems. Okay, so it is very important that below the alert height, you can continue unless the red autoland light illuminates. Above the alert height, if you have a failure on your automatic landing system or you have a failure on the ground equipment such as the localizer, the glide slope, and so on, you have to go around. Okay, so this is a distinct difference between before and after the alert height. The alert height is tested and certified throughout the aircraft certification, and it's around 100 to 200 feet. So on the Airbus A320 is 100 feet, on the Airbus A330, for example, is 200 feet. So the higher, the better, because once you cross the alert height, you can continue unless the autoland red lights will illuminate or you have a major failure. So, but what are these actual failures that will have to make you perform a go around below the alert height? Because we said that below alert height, even though you have a failure, you can continue because the system is considered to be so redundant that an autoland can still be performed. However, as we said, we have this autoland red light that if does illuminate, you have to do a go around. This autoland red light, it depends on the aircraft type, okay? But normally on the Airbus A320, it will illuminate, for example, if both autopilots will trip off. Of course, because if both autopilot trip off, you cannot use the autopilot to do the autoland. Or, for example, you have a radio altimeter failure or a difference on the radio altimeter. If you have a localizer deviation, a glide slope deviation that exceeds certain limits. So, as you can see, big failure will make your autoland lights to illuminate even though you are below the alert height. And in that case, you need to perform a go around, even though you are below the alert height. Okay, guys, so I hope you understand now what is the alert height and why it's so important. So let me know what you think in the comments below. I wish you a good day and I'll see you on the next one.